Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Angie at Chicken Scratch, and this is the project we're making today. Okay, so this is box of the week number one, and I will tell you that originally this was going to be a Halloween project, and then I got this pillow box thinlet that's going to be in our holiday catalog, and I had to switch it up. So next week you'll see a Halloween project. This week, the box of the week is going to be Christmas. Okay, so to make this box, you're going to need two pieces of 6x6 designer series paper. Actually, it can be a little bit smaller, but I wanted to show you that in the holiday catalog, which goes live on September 1st, we have this awesome Merry Moments designer series paper stack that coordinates with the Merry Moments 12x12 paper that's in our annual catalog. So you get 48 sheets, and there's four patterns. So we've got pattern one, pattern two, and then pattern three, pattern four. Okay, so you can make a ton of boxes with just one stack of paper. Okay, so I'm going to get the pillow box thinlet and move this out of the way and get my Big Shot. Okay, so magnetic platform, cutting pad, paper, pillow box thinlet. So you're going to do this two times, okay? Okay, just repeat. Okay, now while I have the magnetic platform and the Big Shot out, I'm going to go ahead and cut out my deco label framelit with the glimmer paper. And I will have some boxes that will not use the Big Shot. I couldn't resist, like I said, the first one being the new pillow box. Okay, so this is really, really, really easy. You're just going to fold on those score lines that the thinlet has made for you. Okay. Now I'm going to show you how this is going to assemble. So this side here is going to attach to this side, and then this side here is going to attach to that side. So the only place you're going to need adhesive are these tabs, or these sides. And you do want to use your tear and tape or a little stronger adhesive. Because this is my sample, I'm not using the stronger adhesive. It's a little bit easier for me to make my project's just using the snail when I'm filming. Okay, so there's that one. Whoops. And then now this side. Now I'm going to show you two ways to close this. I learned this actually at convention. So you can just fold these flaps over. And you want to make sure that if you're going to do that, that both sides, you know, like this goes down and this one goes down. The other thing you can do is, let me make sure I can do it, is, I'm going to have a hard time explaining this. There we go. See? I can't really tell you what that's called. But I can show you on the other side. There we go. See? Okay. I actually don't need it to be closed that way because I'm actually going to wrap ribbon around mine. So that method just keeps the box closed for you if you're not going to use ribbon, but I'm using ribbon. So I'm going to go back to the traditional way. So I'm going to take the stitched satin whisper white ribbon. And then I'm going to use the white not white. What is this? Cherry cobbler baker's twine. I love this stuff. I'm going to be using it a lot. I'm just going to warn you guys. So if you don't have it, you might want to get some. Now this proved a little challenging to get this knot tied and keep the ribbon in place, but the end result is so cute. So what you can do is actually tie a knot first in your baker's twine so that that holds it in place, because if you don't hold it in place, it's just gonna get loose and go everywhere. So now that I've got that knot, now I can just make myself a cute little bow. You don't want to know how long I struggled with that first one. I almost gave up. Okay. There's sometimes I wish that the camera was actually rolling, because you would not believe the mess I make sometimes. Okay. So now I'm just going to trim the ends. We may trim those again in a minute. We definitely need to trim the ribbon. Okay, so now let's stamp. We're going to be using cherry cobbler ink. The stamp set that I'm using today is called Oh What Fun. This is going to be in the holiday catalog. I love it. It's so beautiful. Every one of the images are just beautiful. Yeah, so if you need a greeting set, I think this is an awesome one to choose. And we are using the one that says Do Not Open Till Christmas. So you could actually put this under your tree. Okay, so, and I can't remember if I needed to use the Stampin' Mat with this image. I don't think I did. Nope, stamps perfectly. Sometimes with a photopolymer, you need to use the Stampin' Mat. Okay, 2-inch circle punch. We're going to attach that to the glimmer paper with dimensionals. I lost my words there for a second. I thought about adding something to the bottom down here, but everything that I added, it just kind of made it too much. So I left it a little simple. Now I want to do is place dimensionals on the top and the bottom so that it goes over the ribbon. Like that, okay? Okay, so that wraps up box of the week number one. Have a great day. Thanks a lot. Bye.